Our speaker today is Mr. Todd Bosley, one of our Stark County commissioners. He attended St. Thomas Aquinas High School, Kent State University, Wheaton College in Wheaton, Illinois. He was elected to a four-year term in 2007. Prior to his election, he served as an Emmishillen Township trustee. He served as president on that committee. Owner and founder of Ohio Trading Incorporated, also affiliated with Stark Regional Planning, vice president of the Stark Council of Governments, also associated with Ohio Township Association, multi-county juvenile detention system, and the Joint Solid Waste Management District. I just met Todd about 10 minutes ago. Todd, welcome to Paris.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for having me today. You know, it was at this moment 65 years ago, the final plans were being put in place for the largest military action ever taken by sea. General Dwight Eisenhower was about to launch a very bold and risky campaign to move thousands upon thousands of troops, men from all over America of every conceivable background, to cross dangerous waters and land on Normandy. We, of course, all know the story of D-Day, June 6, 1944, and the amazing bravery and sacrifice made to save the world from the wrath of an awful tyrant and preserve freedom for millions, including all of us, standing here today. Memorial Day is more than parades and backyard cookouts with friends and family. It's more than a day off work or a day off school or the unofficial start of summer. Memorial Day is and always has been a day to stop and remember the brave men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice in defense of this great nation. It is a day to honor those who gave up everything so the beautiful red, white, and blue flag that we see all around us would always remain as a beacon of hope to the whole world. An estimated 2,500 men lost their lives on the beaches of Normandy, but we must never allow them to become just numbers. Each young man who fell that day, as well as those who lost their lives in every war in defense of this nation, had families, mothers, fathers, brothers, sisters, wives, and children. They had hopes and dreams of becoming doctors and teachers, of playing baseball, writing books. They had lives. They were real people, and they were heroes because they gave up their dreams and missed the opportunity to watch their children grow up and grow old with their family so all of us could. 65 years later, their deeds are no less heroic, and it is up to us to make sure that we never forget the price they paid for our freedom. Heroes are not just found on the pages of history books. In 1940, they could be found at Normandy and Iwo Jima. In the 50s, they battled to keep the communists from crossing the 38th parallel. And in the 60s and 70s, they served our nation in faraway jungles, just as the best and brightest of this generation defend our freedom in 100-degree deserts of Iraq and Afghanistan. For more than 200 years, our nation has been blessed to have been served by the best military in the world. Not because of our weaponry, not because of our ships, our tanks, or our planes. We owe our freedom to the young men and women who have given so much of themselves for all of us. I believe we must act every day in a way that we might be worthy of their sacrifice. We can all do a little bit every day to protect the greatness of this country. Men are a child who needs your help. Get involved with the church or your kid's school. So many families have fallen upon hard times and could use a hand getting back on their feet. Our country is at its best when we pull together. People often remind us of the fear we felt as a nation on September 11th. And while it is important that we never forget that Tuesday morning and the tragedy that befell us, I prefer to think of September 12th. Remember the way we came together, all of us, as Americans? The days after we were attacked in New York and Washington, there were no Democrats, there were no Republicans, there were no blacks, no whites, there were no regions and no ideology. We were all Americans. There was no limit to what we could have done for our neighbors, our community, or our nation. If we can harness even a little bit of that every day, there's no limit to what we can do as a people. No enemy, no terrorist, no recession can defeat us when we are united. If we can be the same people we were September 12th, every day, we will be deserving of the heroism of our troops. Finally, I would like to share a story with you of a young American soldier who enlisted in Pearl Harbor. Before deploying overseas, he was warned that in many parts of Europe, people had never seen a black man before, and that he should be prepared for stares and comments once he arrived. In a battle in France, the young man was captured and taken prisoner of war and thrown into a cell with an elderly Frenchman who was suspected of giving aid to the resistance. For a few moments, the Frenchman didn't speak. He only looked wide-eyed at his new cellmate. Finally, the old man, who spoke a little broken English, managed a few words. He looked at him and said, Are you a? The young soldier, remembering what he had been told, expected to be asked if he were black or colored or a Negro, waited for the old man to finish. He finally said, Are you an American? Surprised, the black soldier smiled and said, Yes, I am an American. The elderly man, hearing this, burst into tears, grasped the hand of the soldier and said, Thank you. Thank you, thank you. I couldn't possibly agree more or put it any better. To all of those who have worn the United States, who has worn the uniform of the United States of America, past, present, or future, on behalf of all of us, I say thank you and may God bless you all.